tour display earlier. You'll also see them from Ulaanbaatar, our main event. It's called a Lekker Moon, the traditional gesture performed by Lekker fighters to challenge their opponent with courage and respect. First round of action, Poutor in the white, Yanu Suba in the gold and black. Charging, they are blowing horns, they are playing drums. It sounds like a soccer crowd, a football crowd, but it's a one championship Yangon crowd.
Oh, look at that. Yanu Suba got his leg caught on the kick. Poutor caught it, spun around. Now we get to see what Poutor is like off his back. He's rarely in this position. Look how easily Yanu Suba stepped over that leg into half guard. Let's see if he gets past it in the mouth.
Not where Poutor wanted to be in the opening minute of this mixed martial arts contest. Yanu Suba, as Mitch has said, is a wizard from these sort of positions.
Poutor trying to throw up that rubber guard, trying to keep a nice high guard on Suba, so he's looking for his threatening attacks. You can see him trying to trap the arms there on his chest and possibly looking for an arm bar. Now he's going to open up his legs, attempt a scissor sweep here. He's going to try to slide that right knee across his chest. Yanu Suba's having none of that, catches it, passes into side control here, almost. Look at that knee. Poutor's got to keep that knee there. He can't let that knee get. He's got to keep that knee inside. That right knee of Poutor is the only thing saving him right now. Good job from Poutor to get back into full guard.
Yanu Suba, who began his martial arts training as a 10-year-old in Taekwondo, as a way to deal with his tormentors who have bullied due to his mixed ethnicity, born to a Chinese mother and a Nepalese father.
Poutor's got to get back to the other side. Can't let Yanu Suba get his left leg out of his hand, out of his feet right there. It's a bad spot for Poutor to be in. He's got to try to get his left leg on the other side of Yanu Suba's body.
Poutor was a promising soccer player until the age of 18 when he broke his leg. He was forced to quit playing soccer. Began training the martial art of Litwa, the national martial art of Myanmar. Records exist of Litwa matches dating back to the Payu Empire in Myanmar. They were used to compete in wars against neighboring countries. A devastating martial art, but it's a stand-up martial art. No chance for Poutor to use the Litwa from here.
And Yanu Suba's in full side control now. Now he's going to look to soften up the head. Look at Poutor trying to keep nice and tight. He's trying to get back into half guard. Look at that. Suba's going after the neck now.
Poutor taps it. Good night, Irene! Yanu Suba taps out Poutor in the opening round with a choke. And this crowd falls silent. You could hear tumbleweeds blowing through the Toowoomba Indoor Stadium at the moment. They are shocked.
Look at this. He steps over the head, slides the neck right under the arm, gets both hands clasped. This is what Yanu Suba does so brilliantly. Look at that guillotine. It's so tight. Let's take another look at it. It was that good. He steps over the head, clasps the hands, puts that knee right in the middle of his solar plexus and just starts cranking. Beautiful submission win for Yanu Suba.
The winner's medal will go back to Malaysia around the neck of Yanu Suba as he flies the Malaysian flag over his shoulders. Dominic Lau to enter it into the record books.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Kemp Cheng, has called a stop to this contest after 2 minutes and 47 seconds in the first round for your winner by way of guillotine, Yanu Suba!
A fantastic victory, and look at the sportsmanship. Look at the martial arts Bushido spirit between the two. And the winner's medal goes back to Malaysia with Yanu Suba.
And we're underway, one super series, Muay Thai, with four rounds clubbed. This gets nasty, this gets awesome. And already Mikkios attacking the lead leg of Jordan Boy. You see the sparring of the neck, of the arms, the chest of Mikkios. childhood accident where boiling hot soup was spilled on him. My word, it is deafening in here, Mitch. It is deafening for Jordan Boyd.
Again, he's attacking the legs of Mikkios. Always going out. As soon as Mikkios tries to step forward, puts any kind of weight on that lead leg, Jordan Boyd is laying into it. Look at
the big leg kick from Jordan Boyd. Here comes the Malaysian. They go toe-to-toe now. Mikkios on the front foot. This is nuts. They clinch up for the first time. And referee already now reports that.
Reach disadvantage. He's got to get close. He's got to throw hands with him. He can't stay at kicking range with Jordan Boyd.
Stergos Mikkios in the Greek national colors of white and blue. A proud Greek tradition in kickboxing and Muay Thai. The likes of Stan the Man Longanides, Tosca Petridis, and of course, the great Iron Mike Zambidis. Outside leg kick for Mikkios. Uppercut to an overhand right from the Greek. Both men trade leg kicks. Mikkios fakes. Goes downstairs. Jordan Boyd checks the kick. Jump walking right hand. Oh, the big kibosh! The elbow! The elbow! The elbow!
6, 10, 8.
Mikkios says what happened. Is he okay to go on here? He is caught with an elbow flush of the orbital.
No!
Mikkios still looks right. That was a beautifully timed elbow.
This place is deafening. Here comes Jordan Boyd, a second knockdown. Malaysia goes into meltdown. He's not going to get up. It's goodbye, Irene. Malaysia, Malaysia, Jordan Boyd.
Wow, Muhammad bin Mahmoud, welcome to ONE Championship. He started low and worked his way systematically up the body to finish with a beautiful knockout. Look at this. Mikkios trying to solve the riddle of the reach disadvantage. Flies in with a Superman punch, but then over the top comes an elbow from Jordan Boyd and then jumps all over Mikkios, and Mikkios had enough and a huge win. Muhammad bin Mahmoud.
Absolutely crazy scenes here in Kuala Lumpur. Two knockdowns from Jordan Boyd. And Stergos Mikkios could not get up. The Malaysian flag flies proudly. Let's go to Dom Lau, pandemonium.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Atsushi Onari, has called a stop to this contest after 2 minutes and 20 seconds in the first round for your winner by way of knockout, Muhammad bin Mahmoud.
They are going crazy for Jordan Boyd. The winner's medal stays in Malaysia. Around the neck of Muhammad bin Mahmoud. All smiles here.
Chihim bounds out of the corner. The side kick opens up indeed there for Toma. And again, the side kick lands for Toma.
Taking the feet right out of Rizwan. Look at Toma getting on top. Rizwan scrambling. Look how aggressive she is on the attack. She's always hunting for that leg, Michael.
Mitch, this is a completely different Pooja Toma than we saw last November against Tia.
Now she's on the bottom, though. This is not a good spot. This is exactly where Rizwan wants to be. She's going to try to go knee on belly, spin, and attack that arm. Oh, with the head. Knees. Big knees.
Listen to this crowd. Amethyst strike there from Rizwan. Pooja trying to throw the legs up, trying to trap the neck.
Reverse arm, reverse triangle right there, possibly.
Okay.
Oh, there's the arm bar.
Inside the closed guard of Jihin Rajwan.
Oh, that was the Achilles heel right there, but she defended well, rolled out of it, was able to get back in the mount. You can see Rizwan trying to threaten the high guard. Now she's attacking the arm again.
Second armbar attempt, this one looking a little tighter. Tomar in trouble.
Tomar's got to keep moving.
Down. And she yanked the arm out. It's still stuck.
save her arm.
She's clasping her hands together. She can't let it go. Look for Ruiz one. She has that high guard. That's dangerous. She's Tomar's got to keep her head up. She spreads the triangle. On the triangle, it's in.
This armbar is the chink in the armor of Pooja Tomar. The triangle here from Rajwan.
Oh, Tomar's trying to fight through. That's deep. That's deep, Michael.
That is so deep. And these elbows and these hammer fists to the top of the head. This crowd want to see the finish. They want the Malaysian victory for the teenager. Are they going to get it here?
Oh, look at those elbows.
Are they going to get it here? Kim Ching on top of the action.
Tomar's fighting. Look to see Rizwan trying to transition to an armbar because Tomar's got enough space on that right side of her neck to stay out of it. Look at her. She's turning. She's battling. She's not giving up easy. That's for certain.
Pooja Tomar not waving the white flag.
Oh, there it is.
Goes into meltdown. The teenager, Jihan Rajwan. My word. Could she be the next superstar? Have we unearthed the next big thing?
Well, there was the opening sidekick that you called, Michael. Tomar landed it, swept the feet out from under, but that was her only shiny moment of that round. Rizwan was all over her from the beginning of that interaction, that encounter. Look at this, got the triangle and just kept squeezing with those slides. Got nice and tight and the tap was inevitable. Beautifully done and what a debut.
Unbelievable scenes here in Kuala Lumpur. 19-year-old Jihan Rajwan lives up to the massive hype that accompanied her here tonight. Let's go to Dominic Lau.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Kim Cheng, has put a stop to this contest after 2 minutes and 23 seconds in the second round for your winner by way of triangle choke, Jihan Rajwan!
An emotional moment. Malaysians in ecstasy here for 19-year-old Jihan Rajwan wins by triangle choke.
But Steve, Jeff Huang has never been to the second round. In eight fights, he's never seen the 6 minute of a fight. Nice body shot there though, lands the right hand. Still throwing heat with the strikes. Is Jeff Huang. He's good inside that clinch, able to land knees, land elbows. But Tani just constantly attacking the legs, threatening the takedowns, and dragging the fight down to the ground. Good guard from Jeff Huang. Tani tried to slide that knee pass, but Huang able to get back into full guard.
No holdings.
Jeff Huang had to know that this fight would be a ground war, or at least a clinch war, and he's done his homework in doing so to prepare himself for the ground attempts. But he's getting outmaneuvered when it gets to the ground. Look at this, slides easily into mount. And this is a bad spot for Jeff Huang to be in.
Tani constantly letting his body weight do a lot of the work. Just leans on you and moves around you quickly. And now the elbows and the forearms and the punches again. And this is what really makes this crowd roar.
Jeff Huang did a nice little transition there to get this fight back into half guard, but Tani was able to get back into full guard, apply that hip pressure, spread out the legs, and just sink those hips deep into Huang. He's not doing a lot of damage from the top position, and that's because of the defense of Jeff Huang. He's really able to stop a lot of the ground and pound. And the shots, look at that. He's able to evade all this ground
and
pound.
He's doing a great job, actually, of doing that. With head movement and blocking the punches with his hands.
He's not really taking any damage, Steve, on the ground.
Rear naked choke possibility. That's what the crowd are cheering about. Some work to be done first, though.
Uh-oh, Looks like that hand is under the neck. Jeff Wong's got a hand fight. He's got a hand fight.
He's tapped and it's over. It's another second round win for Aguilantani. 5 in the first, 2 in the second, 7 wins in total. And Kuala Lumpur just love him. The story continues. It's a very engaging one. People love to read this man's story. Love to hear how he's inspired himself. To come from an unhealthy position to a healthy one, and this was a healthy fight for him, Rich.
Oh, absolutely. You know, I'll say this much, just to give Jeff Wong some credit. You know, a fighter like Aguilantani, you have to be very heavy on top to throw some good ground and pound. Every time you throw a punch, you're lifting your weight. And that's a testament to how heavy he is, but Jeff Wong was consistently able to push him off.
Another good win then for Aguilantani with the official decision. Here's Dom Lau.
Ladies and gentlemen, to present the medal for this fight, we have Mr. Asif Khan, Asia Business Manager Cluster for Chevron Lubricants. And now, your referee, Yuji Shimada, has put a stop to this fight after 2 minutes and 26 seconds in the second round for your winner by way of reverse chokehold, Aguilantani!
Big win for Aguilantani. He does it again. That's one of the 2 fights he says he needs before a world title shot. Let's see what happens.
It's time for Muhammad Ayman, who began mixed martial arts after watching YouTube videos of the sport. It's time for him to step up his game now. Defended the takedowns well for most of the first round. There's a flicking high kick from Ayman.
Ayman's got to be careful with the kicks. Chen Lei's shown the tendency to try to catch those kicks, close the distance, and get in tight like this. Here's that body lock again.
However, if Ayman can tenderize the legs of Chen Lei, it will make it harder for the wrestler to shoot in on Ayman. And again, familiar territory backed against this corner. What's Chen Lei looking to do here?
He's trying to take the body lock. He's trying to use his left leg to sweep out the legs. There he goes, transitioning into a single leg. But good defense. I mean, Ayman is on the mat with the Suba brothers, the Leone brothers. He's got Coach DC, Don Carlo all over him, working the wrestling. So he's been there with a lot of high-level wrestlers. So he knows what it's like to have super strong guys holding on to him, trying to take him down. So his takedown defense is looking pretty good. But he can't spend the entire match like this. Chen Lei's showing the aggression, but Ayman is just playing defense at this point. He's definitely scoring in the takedown defense category by stopping the takedowns of Chen Lei at this point. This is probably like the 3rd takedown where he's actually successfully been able to defend it, but he's got to do something with it. He's got to be able to circle around and then let go of some of those punches.
Chen Lei continues to press Ayman up against the corner here. I wonder if the Chinese athlete will break off and try and use those kicks that he had success with in the opening round. Make it the chance now. As Mitch said, former Sanda practitioner of Chinese boxing. Sanda, originally developed by the Chinese military, combines traditional kung fu with modern kickboxing techniques, sweeps and throws. Very popular martial art here in China, Sanda. Thought about a front kick, thought about a round kick to Chen Lei. You see Ayman edging back, does not want to go back to that corner. Spinning back fist there from the Jungle Cat, trying to get a little tricky there. Change up the angles and keep Chen Lei, the Rock Man, thinking. Like to see Ayman use his reach, his long, his lean, he's got some good hands on him, he's got to let them go here. Try and touch up the jaw of Chen Lei.
Yeah, let's see him utilize that jab. Put that jab out there and just earn the respect of Chen Lei, because Chen Lei's just walking forward, trying to hunt him down. He's trying to cut off the ring so he can corner him and get that body lock and look for another one of these takedowns.
Did you expect a little more aggression from Muhammad Ayman here, Mitch?
he's playing his game. This is what he does. This is what we saw him do in previous matches with him. He's always got that clean, slick footwork against Rin Sarab. He won a unanimous decision against Yang Fei. He won a unanimous decision. So he's got a high work rate. He has a good pace on his opponents, but he's got to be more aggressive.
Muhammad Ayman taking a strike south of the border, and he has allowed recovery time here. 5 minutes will be allotted in recovery time for Muhammad Ayman. I think you'll be okay to go on. Doesn't look like it was too hard of an accidental groin strike from Chen Li. Chen Li, very impressive in the opening round. How do you view his second round so far, Mitch?
Second round is the same as the first. You know, he's trying to pressure forward, but Ayman's doing a better job of moving laterally. There's that low shot where Chen Li caught him, and Ayman looks like he's ready to go again, looks like he's okay.
Well, it's an accidental groin strike meant to place on the inside upper thigh of Ayman, and sometimes you go a little too high, that hits a little too low, so to speak. We recommence here in the second round, a very intriguing contest. Now a bit of dancing, a bit of shuffling from Ayman. Leaping left hook and a gut-munching knee from Chen Li. Inside leg. Oh, baby!
Beautifully timed flying knee from Muhammad Ayman.
And now Ayman's put the foot down. He's turned up the pressure. Chen Li edges forward, turning back into the liver there. And another groin strike.
Injury time.
Wow. There'll be more recovery time here for Muhammad Ayman. It was another accidental groin strike.
Yeah, I think Ayman spun into that one. Spinning back kick.
It may have been at the same time that Chen's knee or leg was coming up.
I just think that was completely inadvertent.
It's bad luck, Mitch. Just
yeah,
bad luck.
Look, check this out. He spins. Boom, yeah, there's the knee. The kick at the same time. You can see Chen Li covering up like that.
Nothing
just
malicious
a mistimed
in it.
Shot.
Nothing malicious, nothing intentional.
That'd be hard to do that intentionally, though.
It'd be impressive.
Kind of like that Nguyen knockout of Fong Yang, but it was just a nut shot instead.
Okay. Just a caution here from referee Kim Ching. I don't think he'll be delving into his pocket. He knows that it was unintentional.
Touch. Ready? Go!
Still anyone's bout for the taking. Good right hand over the top there from Muhammad Ayman. Seen some more striking in the second stanza. Have we unofficially gone to ground yet in this round, Mitch?
Chen Li, you can see him dropping that lead hand, and when he does, Ayman's catching him with that right. I'd like to see more of that. I like how he went to the body with the jab, and then he came over the top with the right earlier in the first round. I'd like to see more of that. There's a nice straight left. I like how he's changing stances, confusing Chen Li.
Chen Li's forgotten his kicks. There's a punt kick. But those roundhouse kicks to the thighs, to the head that was serving him well in the opening round, have been one apparent here. A standing attempted shot from Muhammad Ayman. Takes the back of Chen Li. Jungle cat. Figure four around the body. Is it the beginning of the end for Chen Li?
Oh, he's tight. Look at this. He's going palm to palm, so Chen Li can't defend that one hand. Look at him, choking him. Oh, the mouth, tongue's coming out.
Oh, this
is getting
deep. The veins are popping through the forehead of Chen Li. The pressure is on. Can he survive 30 seconds?
Oh, look at how tough the rock man is. Oh!
It's the upset. It's the upset. Thank you, mother, for the rabbits. Muhammad Ayman defeats Chen Li, becomes the first man to do so.
Huge win for Muhammad Ayman. Went after the rear naked choke, but then he remembered his jiu-jitsu. Chose to get back onto the back. Backpack Chen Li, went palm to palm, and finished with a beautiful rear naked choke.
Mitch, we said earlier on in the bout that Muhammad Ayman needed to be more aggressive. He came out in the second round and he turned it up, not one notch, not two notch, but five notches.
Oh, look at this. This is the fourth notch right here. You can see Chen Li trying to fight it off with everything he has, but the choke is so deep. You can see as he's about to fall back. Oh, that's fully under the chin. And he just crumbles back. Timber! And Muhammad Ayman laces up a rear naked choke finish in the second round.
Chen Li tastes defeat. for the first time ever. He is now 8-1, and Dominic Lau will make it all official.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Kemp Chang, has put a stop to this contest after 4 minutes and 35 seconds in the second round. For your winner, by way of rear naked choke, Muhammad Ayman!
A choke of the highest order. Muhammad Ayman does what a lot of people thought he could not do, and that is to put an end to the streak of Chen Li, made even more impressive that Ayman did it right here in Shanghai, China.